Another feature of the auditory system is the fact that the length of the sound that we hear is quite important, and it affects how loud we consider a sound. Now, likely this is only practically used until a certain length of a sound. So if a sound is longer than 300 milliseconds, so 0.3 seconds, then no problem, then the longer the sound is, it's not going to affect the loudness. However, the shorter the sound below that mark of 0.3 seconds, the more quiet it will seem. So in this example, I have three sine tones and they have the same level and they have the same frequency, but they have different lengths. And you can see in the annotation, the blue one is at 0.3 second, the green one is 0.05 second, and the red one is 0.01 second. So definitely different lengths. And at the bottom, you can see this corresponding loudness levels. And you can immediately see from the graph that there seems to be correlation between the length and the loudness. Let's hear it. So, exactly the same frequency, exactly the same amplitude, and yet the blue sine sounds louder than the rest because it is longer than the rest. There is also another type of masking, which is called the temporal masking. And temporal masking is quite interesting because masking can occur even before a sound is played or after a sound is played. So, this is the graph. On the x-axis, this time we have time, not frequency, and on the y-axis we have sound pressure level. We are going to play the masker, a 50 decibel sound, and it plays on its own, it's okay. However, any signal within the next 200 milliseconds after this masker, as long as the level fits within this range, will not be heard due to the effect of post-masking. And if you think about it, remember the integration effect that we don't hear the instantaneous sound, we actually hear an integrated sound over a certain time constant. This is actually this effect. We cannot hear this instantaneous change, the masker is gone, but there is another sound. Because of that integration, we, for a very short while, only 200 milliseconds, we cannot hear other low signals. But there is actually also pre-masking, which means that we cannot hear sounds which happen before we even hear the masker. This is a very short time frame, this is just 50 milliseconds, but it's quite interesting as a feature of our human hearing. And we again have an example for you. You have to watch carefully because these are very low levels. So we have here three signals. And here, for the red, we have this tiny signal, but it is happening in quite a distance from the actual big masker. And same in the back, quite a distance passes and only then do we have the masker. And actually, if we look at the time varying loudness result, we see exactly the same. This is our masker, a big level. But for these tiny tones, we also have the tiny peaks on the loudness scale. However, with the green sound, we have the masker, and immediately after the masker, the small tone, exactly the same as here. If we look at the loudness, there is nothing. Now for the blue, the pre-masking, in here, I will zoom in the graphs, you will see later, is again a very short, low-level tone, but for the loudness, there is nothing here to prove that. See, I zoom in, the signal is there, just so you trust me. Zoom in here, the signal is there, yeah, just after the masker, and again zoom, just before the blue masker, there it is, a very short, low-level signal. So as you see, we had the sounds, we had the tiny quiet clicks for the first signal, nothing for the green or the blue, because they were pre or post mask, depending on where the signal was on the time axis.